First question I always get asked, did you take that picture? No, I didn't take that picture. All my photo friends just give me their pictures indiscriminately. Did I see that picture in black and white? No, and think of the exposure. Yeah, it's like, would you do this for free? Think of the exposure. I like to get paid for my work. Those are the three questions I get asked that I always dread hearing. The answer to the question is my most favorite photograph is the one I haven't taken. Paris and snow, probably my most iconic photograph. That has a very, very, very funny story that goes, but it's long. So my most interesting experience was shooting Paris and snow. I like to play, I like to have fun. I don't take it too seriously, so I'm a bit of a goof, so I like to play. Sometimes I'll walk the scene to see where it is and to see what the light's gonna be. Other times I don't wanna know anything about it. When I go to a new location, if I'm photographing a country, the last thing I wanna know is anything about what it is that I'm shooting. So that what happens is I get hit anew. I don't wanna remove, let's say I go to photograph Yosemite. I don't wanna not take pictures that Ansel Adams took. I wanna have Ansel Adams-ness in my pictures that happen organically and spontaneously. Because the monitor is the window to my image. I need to be able to see what it is I'm going to print, and I need to be able to hold and manipulate colors in ways that fulfill my vision of the image. So calibration and accuracy is singularly the most important thing for me, because the monitor shows me what the printer's gonna do. The monitor shows me how to post-process the file in the way in which the camera captured it. Without a good monitor, it's like taking apart a watch and expecting it to tell time. It's not something I would recommend.